I'm not having this argument. I'm not having this argument. Okay, I am having this argument with myself. What's better, ToDoist or Asana? It's kind of a hard question because there are a lot of different layers within these two applications that contextually make it better for different type of people. So first and foremost, the ToDoist pricing is pretty good. I mean, the free version gives you a few active projects. If you're segmenting your life in a few different buckets, this works really well. You don't have, you know, long activity history, which I dislike. I hate that they did that. But what I do like is that the pro version is so cheap. Now on Asana, you're going to have a bit of a more expensive cost for premium, but the free version gives you a lot more than what you get in ToDoist. From a purely functional standpoint, ToDoist is the simplest and, in my opinion, best app on the market for personal use. You can just like press keybinds and just do so many different things to add tasks. Like if I press A here, it'll quickly add a task. If I go to my desktop, I can quickly keybind something to add tasks like this. It makes it really simple and easy to use. But the only views that you get here are gonna be, for example, in this project, you can go between list and board view. Quickly go between these by pressing Shift V. But this is something that puts it a little bit behind Asana in the sense that Asana in my tasks, you have board views, calendar views, you can attach more files, and you have the ability to segment things by projects at a much better level than you do in ToDoist because of the fact that you also have these different views when you are on premium, like timeline, workflow, dashboard, and even messages between team members. And there's even a goal section that's really convenient for team members as well. Now, what are you noticing across this entire system? I'm noticing the sense that this has all these different reporting capabilities and ways to track workload. That stuff's really nice for teams. But for personal use, it's not exactly the most needed thing on the planet. Here you have pretty nice simple task management as well. Like you can put in something like example task here, and you can put it in the project right here. You can add collaborators, and it's very simple. You can mention people like this. You can mention different tasks as well. Let's create task here. Now, if we go into something like this, you can see that there's even rules. So there's due date is today, move task to due today. I use this at work. This is what I use for my work management. I have Asana as like what we use as our company. So I have all the premium options. What I really do like is the fact that you can add subtasks that have layers, but you can do the exact same thing in ToDoist. You can add multiple tasks like this. Then within those tasks, you can keep going and it just keeps going, keeps going, keeps going. The exact same functionality is within here. You can just go subtask, go within that guy, subtask. And it's very convenient to have these different things. What is different between that two sets of functionality is the sense that Asana actually has the ability to make these tasks have dependencies on the pro plan. So make dependent essentially has it so that, for example, this task can't be checked off until all of these are, or this task can't be done until like this and its subtasks are done. These different things are very convenient for team purposes because people know, okay, well, I can't record a video until it's scripted, or I can't edit a video until it's recorded. And that kind of stuff really does contextually make sense across team members. And that's in ClickUp. It's not in things like Notion, although there are workarounds, but in ToDoist, you don't have that option. Even though on the team plan, it's nice to have a team inbox and everything. It essentially just takes simple task management on a team level, makes it cheaper and then the Asana version. It gets rid of a lot of the like crazy fancy functionality that teams want and need. There's no rules in ToDoist, and that's something that sets it a bit behind because obviously you can get pretty creative with rules, adding rules to different sections. You know, you can do things like how I had the due date is approaching and adding different rules and creating different rules. I really am taking advantage of automation here, but something that ToDoist does a little bit better than Asana would be the natural language processing. Like I can just take a really quick capture, wasn't even on the screen, and do remember to take out the trash every Monday at 7 a.m. and then put it in like the life bucket and then done. And then that's in there. And it's something that was very easy to capture and was very easy to capture for now and forever. Whereas in Asana, yeah, that's a thing, but you can't just like do it 100% through a keyboard and it just doesn't feel as good in my opinion. Like Asana has all the core functionality, but maybe the ways that you go about doing it just aren't as fluid as ToDoist. That's something that I can't even quite describe. Now regarding integration, ironically, there are a myriad of integrations for Asana. Like you can see, this is an insane amount of integrations. ToDoist has minimal in comparison. It can sync with a lot of daily planner apps, which a lot of people like Sensama, AkiFlow, pretty much any daily planner that exists, it'll be able to sync with ToDoist. But I gotta tell you what, ToDoist Google Calendar sync is better and is free. Oh, there's that. In ToDoIst, if I sync my stuff here, so go to settings, integrations, you'll see all these different ones that I have. You can sync right here. So basically you add a calendar and you can pick whether it wants to be all your tasks or a specific project. And then you pick what project it is. And then you can Google event duration default for the different tests that you have. And when you complete it, do they stay on the calendar? They don't have a time of day. Do they sync or not? Then showing this example right here, you can see I've very easily taken the tasks and it syncs like this. Now within Todoist, I may not be able to change this, but it has the default there. So you can tweak how long it'll actually take once it syncs. But I mean, it's so convenient to do this. It's not even funny. Using a system with Google Calendar in your task management, in my opinion, is important because you need a calendar app, you need a task app, you need projects and notes. And Todoist checks off two of the boxes very easily. Here, if you're on a small team, very easily can get away with Todoist. If you're on a bigger team, probably gonna need Asana for the advanced features and whatnot. I would recommend going with Todoist as a personal person thing. And I would also recommend you check out my course on it if you want to improve on it, and check out this video on how to improve your productivity even more.